Anaximander, he was Perisocrates' philosopher and lived in Miletus, one of the cities of Ionia, Greece. He belonged to the Milesian school and received the teachings of his teacher Thales. He succeeded him and became the second professor of this school, where he made Anaximenes and Pythagoras of his pupils. Few of his writings and his life are known today. According to available historical documents, he is the first philosopher to write down his philosophy. Although only one draft of his work survived, Anaximander was one of the first Greek philosophers to emerge at the beginning of the pivotal period, from 700 before Christ to 200 before Christ. Revolutionary thinkers also appeared in China, India, Iran, the Near East and ancient Greek. He was early proponent of science and tried to observe and explain various aspects of the universe, with particular attention to its origins. He said that nature is governed by laws just like human societies, and anything that threatens its balance does not last long. In astronomy, try to describe relationship of celestial bodies with Earth. In physics, he acknowledged that infinite is the origin of all things. His knowledge of engineering allowed him to introduce the sundial for the first time to the Greek world. He made a map of the world that is largely consistent with advanced geographic scales. He was also involved in the political arena of the city of Miletus and was sent as governor to one of its colonies by declaring that it's physical forces, not supernatural forces, that make order in natural. Anaximander is among the first scientists. It is also among the first to use scientific experimentation. Anaximander, son of Brachiades, he was born in Miletus during the third year of the 42 Olympiad, 610 before Christ. According Apollodorus, Anaximander was 64 during the second year of the 85 Olympiad, 547 to 546 before Christ. He died shortly after. A timeline for his work is known impossible. No documents provide time information. Themistius and a Byzantine discourse of 4th century suggested that Anaximander was the first known Greek to publish a work on nature. That is why his texts are the first written prose, at least in the Western world. With the advent of the time of Plato and Aristotle, his work were almost forgotten. His successor under Theophrastus was the one who based on the Meagre information that remained, but we know from Aristotle that Thales, who was also from the Miletus, Biridates Anaximander. It is controversial whether Thales is actually Anaximander's professor, but the latter is not that influenced by the former's theory of water. Everything somehow is derived from water. It is controversial whether Thales is actually Anaximander's professor, but the latter is not that influenced by the former's theory of water. Everything somehow is derived from water. But the agreed thing was that Anaximander belonged to the monastic school, which began with the Ptolemy in Miletus, through Anaximander and ended with Anaximenes. Romanic historic Alienis portrays him as ruler of the Milesian colony on the Black Sea coast. The children mocked Anaximander's seeding, and the latter said he should lean to seeing better for them. The first use of the word infinite is due to Anaximander. He was the first to employ the word origin of things in philosophical context, and for him it was just a time point. An asset arises from anything else that may be. Aristotle mentions in the Book of Metaphysics that pre-Socratic philosophers while looking for the element that goes into the composition of all things. While Thales says it is water, and Anaximenes says it is air. Anaximander understood that the beginning was an infinite mass. They were not subjected to obsolescence, which contained elementary elements from which everything we see now is derived. He developed this theory in response to his teacher's theory that water is the origin of things. For Anaximander, this inherent element cannot be identified as water in Thales' theory, and there is not a middle ground between water and air, or air and fire is thinner than air and fire and more stable than water and air. In nature, for example, water is only liquid and cannot become dry, thus it cannot be the raw material. Neither of these other elements are mentioned. Infinite is believed to be a substance that can encompass all of these contradictions, even though it is wholly unknown to us. Anaximander explains how the four elements of ancient physics, water, earth, air, fire, were formed, and how the earth and its beings were formed through their interactions together. It is believed that the universe arose as a result of the separation of all the contradictions contained in the first element from each other, and that all the dead things belong to that element that came from it infinite. Anaximander predicted the multiplicity of the universe. He assumed that worlds emerge and then disappear for some time, that some are born while others end, and that this movement is eternal. Controversy, Plato and Aristotle, who assumed the existence of only one world. Anaximander says that animals emerged from the sea a long time ago. The first animals were born inside a spinal bark, and as they age, this bark dries and prepares humans to go out and live independently. At first, the humans could not adapt to the conditions and the climate of the air. There is an ancient belief that Anaximander was the first to publish a map of the world. Ancient maps were drawn in Egypt, Lydia, the Middle East, and Babylon to show holy cities, boundaries, and the geological features, but Anaximander innovation lays in his being the whole world. Anaximander was interested in measuring time and introduced the sundial to the Greek world. And according to the Herodotus, they taught the Greeks the art of measurement. Sicero records Anaximander's prediction of an earthquake in the city of Sparta. When he is persuaded the Spartans to leave the city with their weapons due to an imminent earthquake. This is the first video in this channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.